Dear children, welcome to the online video class. Dear children of 7th standard, welcome to the next science class. Have you all done the last activity? Okay, before starting the class, let us recall what we have learned in the previous class. We have learned about heterotrophic nutrition and various types of heterotrophic nutrition. So that is, we have learned about parasites and insectivorous plants. And the last class itself, I told you that we will discuss symbiosis and saprophytes in the next class. In this class, we are going to discuss about saprophytes and symbiosis. Okay. Let us recall what is heterotrophic type of nutrition. So what is heterotrophic type of nutrition? These plants, they cannot prepare their food, so they depend on other plants for their food. So that is called heterotrophic type of nutrition. You have written the definition as homework, I think so. Okay, let us see parasite first. Okay, parasite means, what does it mean? They cannot prepare their own food. So what they do? They curl on some other plants or they bite on some other plants and suck food and minerals from them. The example for this parasite is cascata. Okay, what is the color of cascata? Cascata is yellow in color. It lacks chlorophyll. So it curls on or winds on amarbal. Amarbal is the host plant. In the figure you have seen, know that green color plant is amarbal. That yellow color plant is cascata. And this cascata, it takes the food and minerals from the amarbal plant. The amarbal is called host and the cascata is called parasite. This we have seen in the last class itself. In the insectivorous plants, we have seen about pitcher plant. Okay, the pitcher plant is green. It can't prepare its own food. But what happens? In that soil, the amount of nitrogen is very less. So it eats the insects and takes nitrogen from the insects, and with the help of that nitrogen, it can synthesize proteins to grow. So this is what we have learned in the previous classes. Is not, children? So in this class, we are going to discuss about saprophytes. Take your science book, take your note, take your pen, and take page number 6. Come to the heading saprophytes. Okay, see in figure 1.7, a mushroom is growing on a decayed material. A mushroom is growing on a decayed material. Okay, then see the figure 1.5. So the bread is getting wasted. Okay, see that a bread mold is growing on the bread. A mold, that is a fungi, is growing on the bread. Okay, so this mushroom is also a plant. The fungi is also a plant. Where does it grow? See, this mushroom is growing in a decayed material. Okay, if we leave the food for a long time, what happens? After a few days, we can see a mushroom growth in it, isn't it? Okay, if you are taking a bread, if the bread is moistened and we are leaving it for some time, what happens? The bread will be getting black patches or green patches. What does it mean? Some organism is growing on that bread. Some organism is growing on the decayed food. So these are called as saprophytes. Okay, these are called as saprophytes. Okay, so what does it eat? It eats dead and decaying matter. It gets its food from dead and decaying matter. It gets its nutrition from dead and decaying matter. Okay, so it is called parasites. Okay, see, Buju is asking one question. Okay, read that Buju's question, all of you. Okay, read that Buju question. Buju wants to know how organisms acquire nutrients. They do not have mouth like animals do. They are not like green plants as they lack chlorophyll, but cannot make food by photosynthesis. Okay, so Buju wants to know how these organisms get their food. Take a mushroom. Okay, how this mushroom is also an organism, isn't it? How this organism get this food? Okay,
They do not have mouth like animals do. We have mouth and animals have mouth. No, they do not have any mouth. Does mushroom have any mouth? No, it does not have any mouth. Okay, does it have chlorophyll and looks green color? No, it is not at all having chlorophyll also. It is not at all having mouth also. Then how it gets its nutrition? How it gets its food? Where the mushroom grows? The mushroom grows in decaying organisms. So the mushroom is getting food from the decayed material. That is, the mushroom is getting food from the spoiled food materials, isn't it? Have you all understood? Okay, then take your see, a bread mold is growing on the fungi, isn't it? Okay, a bread mold is growing on the bread. So this is also a fungi. Okay, this is also a fungi. Okay, then okay, so underline the word. Okay, you take your book and underline. Okay, these organisms are called fungi. Okay, so they are going on dead and decaying matter, no? So they are called fungi. Okay, they secrete digestive juices on the dead and decaying matter and convert into a solution. So what they do? They will secrete some digestive juices. Okay, some digestive juices are secreted on the dead and decaying material, and nutrients are released. And nutrients are released. So these nutrients are absorbed by this fungi. Okay, underline the line part. This mode of nutrition in which organism taking nutrients in solution form from dead and decaying matter is called saprophytic nutrition. Have you all understood? Okay, so what this fungi will do? Fungi, mushroom is also a fungi. Okay, bread mold is also a fungi. What they will do? They are secreting some digestive juices. They are also living organisms. So they are secreting some digestive juices. And some nutrients are released. So what they will do? These nutrients will be taken by this organism. So these nutrients from dead and decaying organisms will be used by this fungi. So where they get this nutrition? Fungi, they get the nutrition from dead and decaying organisms. So such type of nutrition is called saprophytic nutrition. So such type of nutrition is called saprophytic nutrition, and the plants who use this saprophytic type of nutrition are called saprophytes. Okay, underline the word saprophytes and underline saprophytic nutrition. Okay, so examples of saprophytes are fungi. So mushroom is also a fungi, bread mold is also a fungi. Okay, so this type of nutrition is called saprophytic nutrition. You might have also seen some fungi will be growing on pickles, isn't it? If the pickle is spoiled, what they will do? They will secrete, they will grow on that pickle, and they will secrete some digestive juices, and some nutrients will be released. These nutrients will be taken by this fungi as their food. Okay, have you understood, children? Okay, now Pagali is asking one question. Okay, read the question. Read the question by yourself. Okay, let me read once again. Pagali is keen to know whether her beautiful shoes, which she wore on special occasions, were spoiled by fungi during rainy season. She wants to know how fungi appear suddenly during the rainy season. Okay, Pagali has one beautiful pair of shoes that she used to wear that on occasional days, special occasions she used to wear. Okay, one day she is seeing that in rainy season some fungi appear on that. Why? Why? Okay, in rainy season we know the climate will be very chill, humidity will be more. On that season the fungi growth will be more. Okay, but during the summer season the humidity will be less, the fungi growth will be also less. Have you all understood, children? Have you all understood? Okay, if you have any doubt, okay, message me. I will be there to explain you. Okay? Yes. Then the next one is, okay? Okay. Buju's question and Pahali's question. Buju says once his grandfather told him that wheat fields are spoiled by a fungus. He wants to know if fungi causes diseases also. Okay, what I told, the fungi, what is the food of fungi? They live on dead and decaying organism. Somebody told that fungi cause diseases also, isn't it? Yes, some fungi causes diseases also, but some fungi are used for medicinal treatment also. Some fungi are used as antibiotics also. Whenever we have fever or cold, we are taking antibiotics. No, that antibiotics also prepared from this fungus only. Okay, then Seema, Pakhali is asking, telling the answer. Pakhali told that many fungi like yeast and mushroom are useful. Yeast is used in cake preparation, it is used in food preparation also, it is used in fermentation of puliki vekkadhu help pannu. Then mushrooms, they are used for cooking purpose also. Okay, they cause diseases, at the same time they are used as medicines also. They are also very good antibiotics. Okay, have you understood, children? Okay, then Seema, then take your book page number. Take your book page number 7 and underline the second para. The fungal spores are generally present in the air. So the fungal spores, okay, spores means what do they? This fungi will burst and they will release the spores. So they are present in the air. When they land on wet region means somewhat humidity will be high, and warm regions, if the temperature is somewhat warm, not at all too hot and not at all too cold, they will germinate and they will grow. Okay, that's why the fungal growth is more during the rainy season than the winter season, than the summer season. Okay, then have you all understood, ma? Have you all understood saprophytes? So what is meant by saprophytes? They get their nutrition from dead and decaying organism. And what they will do, when the climate is warm and the climate is wet, means they will burst and release their spores and they will germinate and they will be growing as a new organism. So fungal growth will be more common in the rainy season than the summer season. Have you all understood, children? Yes, good. Then we are going to see the next topic, symbiosis. Okay, we are going to see the next topic, symbiotic relationship, that is meant by symbiosis. Okay, so what happens means some organisms live together. Okay, two organisms live together. Why they live means to share the shelter and nutrients. Okay, in order to share the shelter and nutrients, they live together. So that is called symbiotic relationship. Underline, take your book and underline. Some organisms live together to share shelter and nutrients. This is called symbiotic relationship. Okay, for this, what example we can give? Okay, some fungi will be living in the roots of the trees or plants. For example, rhizobium bacteria. Bacteria and fungi, they are different. Okay, rhizobium bacteria lives in the root noodles of some plants. Like that, some fungi also will be living in the roots of some trees. What this fungi will do? Okay, some fungi, they will give food, they will take shelter. Okay, they will take shelter and the tree will give food for this fungi. Okay, listen, what the trees will do? The trees provide nutrients to the fungi, receives help from water and minerals from the soil. This is associated, very important to the tree. Okay, what the tree is doing? The tree is giving nutrients to the fungus. Okay, for that, what the fungus is doing? The fungus is helping the plant to absorb more water and minerals in order to prepare its food. Okay, then see, one more example is given, lichens. What is that example? Lichens. Okay, and the lichens means an algae and the fungus live together. In the lichens, what and are living together? An algae and the fungi. Okay, we know that algae is green, isn't it? So it can prepare the food. Okay, it prepares food and gives to that fungi. Okay, so what the fungi is doing? The fungi provides shelter and water, minerals to the alga. Okay, so it was the fungus like a mushroom, no? You have seen the mushroom, isn't it? So the mushroom is giving, that is the fungus is giving shelter, water and minerals to the alga, and the alga is giving water to the fungus. Water and food to the fungus. So this is symbiotic relationship. That is, they share together. In lichens, there are two organisms. One is the fungi, other one is the alga. The alga is a chlorophyll containing partner. So it prepares food and gives to the fungus. For that, the fungus, what the fungus will do? The fungus, it gives shelter to the alga. So there is some adjustment between one organism and other organism, and they live together. So this is called symbiosis relationship. Okay, have you all understood the today class, children? Okay, I will tell the activity.
Dear children, your activity for this class is you have to frame 20 fill in the blanks in saprophytes and symbiotic relationship, and also find out the answers. And the second one is you have to write short notes on saprophytic nutrition and symbiotic relationship with examples. So this is your activity. Do it and submit your class teacher. Have a nice day. Thank you. See you again in the next class.